Here post game with head coach Jim Penders, the Huskies able to steal one tonight, 3-1. As coach, when do you think that game turned in your favor? It felt like that seventh inning, Caleb comes in, gets out of a massive jam, second and third, nobody out.
Unbelievable emotional lift, but then I think we went 1-2-3 mm-hmm. after. That was the frustrating part. I thought we had better at bats. I mean, I know they weren't falling. It seems like it's impossible to get something down in this outfield. I mean, they cover a lot of ground. Wingo made an unbelievable play on Kyler Fedko's ball in right field. It's just not falling. But I thought we had much better at bats. We got on top of a few more baseballs today, hit them in the opposite field. Woody leading off, you know, the 11th there with the line drive up the box, and then two great sacrifice bunts from our two and three hitters after our four hitter doesn't get it done earlier in the game. But I thought, yeah, Caleb Worcester, second and third, nobody out, and he comes in and just shoves. I mean, he was throwing fastballs by guys, and he was moving all over the place, got some really bad swings, and that really was, I thought we captured some momentum, and then it's like, you got to go with your closer. You know, I mean, after he did what he did, and then goes back out, does it again, we're going with Jake there and throwing all the chips in the middle of the table and letting it ride. And I'm glad that he came through. He's just been so good.
How much confidence does that give your offense, similar to Texas State, where it's, all right, Jake's in the game, all we need is to do is push a couple across?
Yeah, they know you got to get one. You know, I mean, that's the mentality. Just let's scratch one across and Jake's going to hold it. And fortunately, we got two, little insurance there. But he's been electric and automatic. And, you know, I'm just so proud of the way that he competes. And his development's been extraordinary over the course of his 3 years. So he's still got room to grow, too. That's the scary part, but he's been sensational. And you know, I was just proud of I was proud of our fight. You know, I thought we gritted one out. It was saying in the dugout, hey, we got to be tougher, we got to be mentally tougher, we got to be mentally tougher, because that's a tough bunch over in the other dugout. But I thought we kind of fueled off of Caleb. You know, Randy was good, and then it was like, oh boy, you know, it turned sour quickly. The crossed up, you know, crossed that up, couldn't see the signs, that can't happen. And then Caleb just kind of righted the ship right then, and then they didn't do much after that.
How about the at-bats for Christian Fedko going to the opposite field? It's kind of a bummer that you got your walk with nobody out in the ninth, because Christian had to bunt there and not swing away.
Yeah, I got to have him bunt there, you know, and they know, hey, everybody's got to be capable of doing that at any point. We don't have anybody that is exempt from bunting. We don't have that guy in our lineup anymore. He's got to be able to do it, and he can do it. You know, he just didn't get it down. But then he had two guys, you know, two veteran guys, a couple seniors, or a junior and a senior, really get it done there. Perfect bunts. I mean, Anthony Prado couldn't have rolled it out there better. And Tope just getting it to that side, to the third base side, had third baseman have to commit. That's what happened, and he did a great job too. So, and then I know it was a wild pitch that scores him, but Anthony Prado with a great base running play. You know, I trust him completely. I've trusted him since maybe his second or third game with us as a freshman at Port St. Lucie. I said, geez, this kid's on a different level in terms of his baseball IQ and his base running ability. So as that ball's in the air into right field, I'm saying, hey, your read here, which I very rarely say, mm-hmm. your read here, I trust you. And then as it's coming down, I'm saying, I think you got a hold. And he trusts his instincts and trusts his gut. And what he did there was he slid late through the plate like we teach, but we don't always see. Mm-hmm. You know, Chris Winkle had an opportunity to do that earlier in the game on a contact play and elected to pull up. Wasn't sure he could score. I think if he went in the same way Anthony did, he probably scores. So lesson to be learned. And he's a coach on the field the way that he plays the game. So that was a big base running play too, just to push that extra run and give us another emotional lift. But big time team win tonight, getting even on the road going into Sunday.
So do you feel going into tomorrow that you haven't even laid your best punch so far this series and have an opportunity tomorrow?
Yeah, we certainly haven't offensively. I mean, our pitchers have been very good. Our pitching's been very, very good. Their pitching's been very good. I mean, they have limited the free 90. They won the battle of free 90s again tonight. We got a couple fortunate ones late, but holy cow, they've done a super job. And their starter tonight was very good. You know, he hasn't had great numbers, but he was very good tonight. And we got to find a way to have a little bit better at bats. Although I liked our contact. I liked our fight. I don't think we struck out until maybe the seventh or eighth inning tonight. So put a lot of balls in play. Just they weren't falling. And as long as we fight like that, I'm okay. But yeah, you're right. We haven't thrown our best punch yet offensively, and we're going to need to score some runs, I'm sure, tomorrow. Generally on Sundays, you got to score runs to win.
Thanks, Coach.
Thanks, Chris.